Now listen, if there's one thing that I love to do is that remarkable experience of just getting below the surface, knowing you can breathe because you got the scuba equipment on, and all of a sudden you're an astronaut. You're weightless, you are in an alien environment. And if you're John Chatterton, of course, you're home, because that's his office. 57 dives, for crying out loud. That's just on the History Channel itself. How many total? Do you ever count them all?
You know, I spent more than 20 years working as a commercial diver in and around New York City, so I have well over 10,000 dives. Some of them in hard hats, some of them in rebreathers, some of them in scuba, and some of them, like on Titanic, in submersibles.
And you're going to be talking about them all at the Phoenix Dive Show.
The Phoenix Dive Show is this weekend. I'm doing a couple of presentations, one on Saturday, which is about Titanic, and another one on Sunday, just about scuba diving on shipwrecks and ways that divers can maybe improve their game.
We've had Robert Ballard down here, Dr. Ballard, who discovered the Titanic.
Sure.
It's such an extraordinary subject to talk about. People watch the movie, the dramatized movie, over and over and over again, and here it is, and it's breathtaking. Tell me what it is when you're down there, though, looking at this.
Well, we were diving from the Mir submersibles off the Russian research ship Keldysh. Every minute down there is valuable in pretty much any way you would like to value time. We get down there, we have work to do, trying to learn as much as we can about the wreck. Now, you leave the surface in the Mir submersible, it's a 6-foot sphere, essentially, and you've got a pilot and you've got two crews, so there's three of us jammed into this 6-foot sphere. The interior of the sphere is lined with equipment. Of course, it's a Russian submersible, so, you know, much of the equipment is working, but you know, you get down there. It's a two and a half hour drop down to the wreck, and you know, because of ocean currents and just the fact that you've jumped almost 2.5 miles, you need to orient yourself. You need to figure out where you are. You need to get your coordinate system plugged in, and then you want to go wherever it is you want to go. And you know, after a 2.5 hour drop, you've got 5 to 6 hours on the bottom, and then it's another 2.5 hours to ascend. The limiting factor being the power that you're consuming in with the Mir. So that's essentially your fuel. So, you know, I mean, you get down there, it is that 5 to 6 hours on the bottom, it seems to go by like that.
And as someone who has always been totally devoted to the world of science, I have one question that I hope isn't too complex for you. How do you go to the bathroom?
Well, the Russians measure a man by his ability to hold it.
That's why Russians are often in a bad mood. Have you ever noticed that?
Your worth as an individual is measured by urinary output.
We got to tell Putin, find a John somewhere, anywhere at all.
Well, you know, you intentionally dehydrate yourself before the dives, and afterwards, you know, when the hatch flies open, you know, they want to take a picture of you waving to the crew of the Keldysh, and you're like, yeah, okay, I got something I got to take care of. I'll be right back.
All right, so James Cameron, the director, the Academy Award-winning director, he always reminds us of Titanic, is diving now himself to depths that nobody ever considered before. How deep can we go?
To the bottom.
But the bottom is so heavily pressurized. I mean, the whole concept of being crushed, as a matter of fact, if you're not pressurized properly below the surface of the water, how soon are you in trouble?
Well, you really have to address the issue of pressure at anything really below 30 feet. Ambient pressure, it impacts the human body's the human physiology in a way that we have to start keeping track of the time. We have to start keeping track of depth, at really any depth over 30 feet. But you know, Titanic sister ship, Britannic, was sunk in World War I, struck a mine off the island of Chia in Greece. That's in 400 feet of water, and it's laying on its port side or starboard side. That wreck, really at 400 feet, is really at the limits of scuba divers. So divers utilize a device called a rebreather. This is a diving apparatus in which divers' exhaled gases go through a closed loop. CO2 is absorbed by a chemical absorbent, and sensors detect how much oxygen is. It's very sophisticated, but enables divers, you know, manned individuals to dive deeper.
How disciplined are you, though? Can you, in 30 seconds, tell everybody in our audience right now, because we are tight on time, where you were 9/11?
9/11, I was working on a commercial job underneath the World Financial Center, directly across the street from Tower One.
I mean, that in itself, with this lifetime of adventure that you've had, and you wind up there under the water while it's happening. I don't know whether you're going to tell that story this weekend, but Saturday and Sunday, Phoenix Convention Center. The dive show. And you know what? If you have never been below the water without floaties, I can only tell you, my friends, this is a weekend of excitement and adventure, courtesy of our guest, John Chatterton, who is always invited back here to the Morning Scramble.
It's time now for CenturyLink. You make the call. Be-